Can somebody say amen? Scripture is fulfilling. Or people can cry tears. We can sympathize with one another. It's part of human nature. But no doubt, amidst all the deaths, the suffering, and the plagues that are hitting the land, Scripture is fulfilling. We read in Ezra, Cyrus spoke so that it can be fulfilled what was written by Jeremiah. We read in the book of Matthew, there was a census that took place so that it can be fulfilled what was written by Isaiah. We saw in the Gospels, there are many places that the Bible says this happened so that it may be fulfilled. And the day as the bride, we come to terms with such statements. Our reaction to circumstances are going to be different. The reason we behave the way we behave amid these calamities is because we do not connect the events with what was written before. The reason we cry desperately and hopelessly and seek solution in places we are not supposed to seek solutions for is because we are failing to marry the events with the prophecy of our day. By the time you recognize that, whatever that takes place will not make you pray irrelevantly. Prayer is not changing the mind of God. If God says people will die because of COVID, prayer is not going to change anything. Because the prayer of the bride, it is to change her mind that it can be in alignment with the will of God. And it's important to know the will of God. You see, there are times in life where you can see a brother struggling. He can't get a job. He has no money. And he's suffering. And yet God doesn't want you to help that man. You get the point? Because according to God's plan and purpose, that brother must pass through that adversity so that he can fulfill the purpose for which he was expressed into time. But when you feel that you have sympathy more than God, you are more remorseful than God, you are going to be found trying to do God a service without it being His will. But when God opens your eyes and you understand things for what they are, you no longer pray to God. You pray with God. You are saying, Lord, before I start to pray, what is your will? And I want to pray with you. The Holy Ghost speaking through my lips. Intercessions that man cannot utter. I want to pray in line with your purpose for the hour. That is what we call true prayer. Or a prayer of faith, which is a prayer of revelation. It is not praying to God, but praying with God. And how do you pray with God? You pray with God when you are one with God. When you are in Him and He is in you, then when you stand before His presence, you are not praying circumstantially. You're not praying conditionally. You're not praying according to your feelings. You're not praying according to discipline or routine. But you're praying because of a relationship with God.
Can somebody say amen? Let it be the name of the Lord. Jesus, when he said, "Thy will be done," he was now praying with God. Not my will, but thine, O Lord. His will was contrary to the purpose of God. So he had to submit his will to the purpose of God. Some of you are in problems. You're wasting time trying to pray yourself out of your problem. But God put it for a purpose. When you start to pray with God, you're not going to be crying. You thank God for your unpleasant circumstances. You thank God for your trial. You appreciate God for the adversity you are going through. Because now you are praying with God in the midst of pain. You are blessing his name. After a tragic accident, you are saying, "Be magnified." After the doctor diagnoses an incurable disease, you still stand and say, "Blessed be the name of the Lord." After you lose your loved one, the person you loved, people that were close to you, you say, "Thank you, Lord." You give and you take. Now you are praying with God. You pray to God. And that is what we need as the bride in such a time as this. Glory be to God.